bonus.
Hi everyone, it's John.
And Ben.
And it's time for another
Ben's Bonus.
And today it's the return of the Monster High Frightmares.
Yeah.
Not necessarily a return to stores, but a return to our channel, because we've had these for
a long time. I had to brush the dust off of them. We've had them so long.
So, these are the centaur type Monster Highs that are half horse, half Monster High. We did a series of these before. I will link to that video up in the corner and down below, so you can watch that vintage Ben's Toyman video.
Hopefully we don't have any of these.
Hopefully they're not repeats.
Hopefully
not. I think you determined that these were not repeats.
I think so.
But we've said that before.
Yeah, we have.
And then I linked to the video. I was like, oh, there it is right in the thumbnail.
It's been so long and they're not out of storage yet, so I don't know. But I'm excited about these. This one I really like already, and this one I really like already.
So, Pennypole, Steamtail, Flare Ablaze, Fontaine, Fallowheart, and Skyra
Bouncegate.
Okay, those are interesting names. And when we were at Five Below a week or so ago,
we found this variant on Ghoulia, which,
from the vinyl figures,
yeah, which we had not seen ever. And apparently nobody has seen it, so this is exciting. This is like
on
new
Instagram. Chad Allen said he had never seen it before either.
Yeah, and they were, him and I think Mommy and Gracie, they were both looking for these and never found them in stores, and then voila, they're all at Five Below.
Yeah,
so,
that's the only vinyl figure they had at Five Below, yeah. This variant, and they had like dozens
50.
Of it.
Yeah, they had a lot of them.
So if you're looking for this figure, check out and see if there's a Five Below around, because that's where we found her.
Yeah.
So let's open up all of these and come back, and then we will unbox this one last.
Right. So the back of the package, here's Flare Ablaze. Even though I've often been accused of fanning the flames of chaos, I like to think that what I really do is provide the sparks of transformation that turn old sticks in the mud into Roman candles of celebration. So she is a drama starter? Is that what I'm getting out of that? And Fontaine Fallowheart. My friends say I'm a little bit quiet and a little bit shy, and I suppose they're a little bit right. Although I prefer to think of myself as a gentle, which suits me right down to the ground. And Skyra Bouncegate. I've been accused of being perky, but I prefer to think of myself as energetic. And it's a good thing, too, because it takes a lot of energy to cheer on the herd and encourage them to go fight, win!
Okay, I dug up the video. I dug up the original Frightmares video.
And we have them all! No.
Apparently Creepy Twilight came out for this one.
Yes, because she was trying to get people to say she was more creepy than the Monster High Frightmares. None of these are on there.
Yay!
So, Pennypole Steamtail. I'm a finely tuned Frightmare who's geared to trot like a top. I believe precision makes the world go round, and that includes getting my name right. It's Pennypole. Please pronounce it precisely.
I thought like Pennypole. Like Penelope.
Yeah, maybe it's Pennypole. Yeah, that would make sense. Pennypole.
So
she didn't tell you phonetically how to say it. She just spelled it out, which does not help, by the way.
Okay. So the back of this one says, "I've been accused of being perky, but I prefer to think of myself." You read them all as I was looking up that video?
Yes, I read all these already.
What? And we're back with the Frightmares out of the package. And Ben, I thought the Pennypole. I hope I'm saying your name right. I'm sure we'll be corrected in the comments. Looks an awful lot like Sci-Twi from the Equestria Girls, with the glasses, the hair. She's kind of like steampunk wings, though, like with gears and stuff.
Yeah, but she also has a unicorn horn.
I know. She's an alicorn.
She is an alicorn. She may be a self-made alicorn.
But the color scheme, I mean, there are gears on this. Look, they even have cutie marks. I'm sure we said this all a couple years ago in our first video. I think she might be pretty creepy. I mean, she's half human, half pony. She may be the creepiest Twilight I've ever seen.
You think so?
Wait a minute! Wait a minute! What am I hearing here?
Hello, creepy Twilight.
What? We're doing these again?
Yes.
What is this? Like 2002 or something? Is that when you did that video?
It was a while ago, yes.
What is this thing? It's like a half human, half pony.
Yes. Quite creepy, don't you think?
No! It's not as creepy as me, right, guys?
Oh, jeez. You can't even do a Monster High video without you showing up.
I'm crashing the party. Get out of here.
Hey, 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 hey. That's not very nice.
I'm going to use my magic and get rid of her.
You don't have any magic in that horn. I guess Penipole does, though.
Penipole. You want to call her Penelope.
Yes, I do. She has magic in her horn, though, I guess.
Moving on to the cheerleading squad.
Mm.
There is Skyra, who's like part ghost, too.
I know, I like this one. It kind of reminds me of Canterlot High with the...
They're like half Equestria Girl and half MLP.
Yeah.
Almost have a Princess Luna vibe going on this one.
I know. It's really cute. I do like the bow on her tail, and I love how she's kind of ghosty.
So we're probably going to be comparing each one of these to a Equestria Girl.
Yeah, probably.
So here's Princess Luna.
I really like the outfit. I do like the little,
These are Equestria Girls, sorry, Ben. These are Equestria Girls if they, like, get caught in the middle of the mirror.
Yeah, they're like, ah, help, help! She has the, megaphone cutie mark going on. These are really cute. I like how their outfits are, you know, interchangeable. You can take them off and change them with someone else if you wanted to. I like her. She's very pretty.
So this one is kind of like a Fluttershy type color scheme. This one, on the other hand, I can't think of an MLP equivalent because this is like more deer-like.
Mm-hmm.
Complete with like the antlers headpiece. It's kind of creepy. I said it again. That she has like skull, like look almost like, are those deer skulls in her headpiece and like bird skeletons?
Well,
I mean, it's a very pretty doll, but man, I don't think even Creepy Twilight's gone as far as wearing pony skulls in her hair.
Well, she's one with the nature, you know, energy gets reabsorbed into the ground and stuff. So, you know, maybe that has something to do with it. Even the flora fauna that is on her outfit here has a little skull in it.
So that was Fontaine.
Yes, this is Fontaine. So she's kind of like a deer. She even has a deer tail. Isn't that cute?
That's an interesting variation on the pony idea.
Yes.
You know, most of them are like the...
Like ponies, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
She's very pretty. You know, she has like the... She doesn't look like Fluttershy, but she has like the Fluttershy-esque personality according to the box. But she's very pretty.
Now, this one over here kind of reminds me of Fluttershy. Kind of, sort of.
Like Sunset Shimmer.
Just the hair and the color scheme and the wings.
I love her tail. Look at this tail. It's like a fire. She has, like, you can barely see it, but there's orange and pink in her hair. There's orange in there.
So I think you're right. Instead of Fluttershy, I think she'd probably be closer in theming to Sunset Shimmer.
Yeah, I think so.
I'm sure Mattel is just thrilled with us comparing every one of their toys to the rival toy company.
They don't care. So this is pretty cool. I like her theming as well. I love the gold wings.
They're not watching this.
No, they're not watching. Doesn't matter.
All right, last but not least, let's take a look at this variant that we didn't even know existed.
No.
From the vinyl figure. It's been forever since we've seen any new vinyl figures.
I am so excited about this Ghoulia. Maybe you can find the original Ghoulia and we can compare.
Ben was looking for the other Ghoulia vinyl figure and found the old Frightmares. This one definitely caught our eye. The hair is like hollow plastic. It's not vinyl like the rest of the figure. But you can definitely see how eye-catching this is. So shiny. Ben's back. I was just telling everyone. That's like a hollow shell. It's not vinyl.
Oh. Interesting. So they didn't just paint this mold a different color.
She has like a tattoo on her torso that says Ghoul Genius. And it's like her insides, or like her organs and stuff, are like tattooed on her outside. That is such a nice figure. Such a great variant. I'm not sure.
Is it brains because she's a zombie?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I bet those aren't organs. I bet those are supposed to represent brains.
Here are the two side by side. So they're, you know, the same body mold and everything. And even the hair is the same mold. But like John said, this one is plastic and this one is a hollow vinyl. But they're really cute. I really like this variant of Ghoulia.
I wonder if there are any other, like, variants that are floating around out there.
I don't know. There was a variant on Deuce. One had, like, clear glasses, one had sunglasses. I didn't get the variants on that, I don't believe. I think I just got one because it wasn't really that different.
I can't remember. When you're unpacking,
I can't remember.
For all we remember, we could have got it.
We could have. But, like, the other ones, you know, like Claudine and Draculaura and those. We have all of those variants.
So did you have a favorite Frightmare? I think mine actually is, I like the deer one just because it's so different.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously I like this one because we can put her on the Twilight shelf.
Mm-hmm.
She'd fit right at home.
I think I like the ghost. What was her name?
Skyra.
I like Skyra because I think she fits in with Monster High quite well. But like Fontaine, I like her, but she kind of looks like she belongs at Ever After High, not Monster High.
Oh yeah. And we both love this very,
yes,
almost chrome looking Ghoulia figure.
Yeah, definitely.
But guys, I am still the creepiest pony, right? None of these, right? Be sure to vote for Creepy Twilight in the poll card on this Bins Bonus. How'd I do?
Let us know which one of these was your favorite down in the comments.
Mm-hmm.
If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to our channel.
And like and comment.
You can also see what Ben and I are doing on our daily vlog channel.
And you can check out some of our other toy reviews.
We'll see you next time, everybody.
Bye.